Okay, good morning students. Today we are going to learn about two important topics in Boolean algebra, that is mean terms and max terms. Okay. Boolean expression is an expression that results in a Boolean value. So you know what is a Boolean value. Boolean value means either it is a true or a false value. So we use the Boolean expression for comparing Boolean variables. So here an example is given. F of a comma b. F a b means f is the resultant Boolean expression which contains two Boolean variables a and b. So the given expression is f is equal to a bar dot b plus a dot b bar. Right? Now we have another definition. So what is a literal? So you can see a literal means, here we can see that in this given expression, a bar is a literal, b is a literal, a is a literal, b bar is a literal. So we can say that any boolean variable is a literal. So when we say the boolean variable can take two forms. What are the two forms? That is either its normal form or its complement form. Right? So here we are going to define what is a mean term. So mean term, we can simply say it is the product term. So when we say the product term, it is the product of two Boolean variables. So we know that the Boolean variable can have two forms. That is either its normal form or its complement form. So that is why we are representing in the example the mean terms as x bar dot y bar, x bar dot y, x dot y bar and x dot y. Right? So these are the possible combination of mean terms or the product terms. Right? When two Boolean variables are joined with an AND operator, that resultant terms are called the mean terms, right? Okay, next we are going to see what is a max term. So when two Boolean variables are joined with an OR operator, the resultant terms are called the max terms, right? So here on the screen you can see that we have two variables, say x and y, right? So these x and y are connected with an OR operator. Then the possible combination of x and y are given as x bar plus y bar, x bar plus y, x plus y bar and x plus y. So these OR terms are called the max terms. Okay, when two Boolean variables are joined with the OR operator, the resultant combinations are called the max terms, right? Okay, here is an important information about the max terms and mean terms. Okay, please see this. When we say zero in max term means the Boolean variable is in the normal form. 1 means the variable is in the complement form. Let me repeat again. In case of max terms, 0 means the Boolean variable is in the normal form. 1 means it is in the complement form. And we use the uppercase M for representing a max term. In the case of mean term, in case of mean terms, 0 means the Boolean variable is in the complement form and 1 means the variable is in the normal form. We use the lowercase m for representing a mean term. I hope you understand this. Please read this again. Okay, here I got an example for you. X, Y and Z are 3 Boolean variables. So the values for x, y and z is given. So it is given that x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, and z is equal to 0. So when we form the mean time using the given information, that is x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, and z is equal to 0. So we know that in mean time, 0 means the Boolean variable is in the complement form. 1 means the variable is in the normal form. So we can say it is the product of x bar dot y dot z bar, because the given values of x is equal to 0 and z also 0. So that is why we put x complement and z complement. So it is a product of x dot y dot z. Right? Here is another example. So here two Boolean variables are there, say x and y. And the value for x is given as 1 and value for y is given as 0. So we can form the mean time using the given values, that is x dot y bar, because x is 1 and y is equal to 0. X1 means the variable is in the normal form, and y bar means, or y equal to 0 means, the variable is in the complement. I hope you understand this, right? Now we can see the examples related to the max times, right? So when we say max time, the variables or the literals are joined with the OR operator. So it is given that x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, and z is equal to 0. When we form the max time for the given values, we know that in max time, 0 means normal form, 1 means complement form. As x is given as 0, so we can say the variable is in the normal form. That is x. In max time, variables are joined with the OR operator. So we can write x plus, and given value of y is equal to 1, that is y bar. Again, joining with the plus operator, that is y bar plus z is 0. So that is in the normal form. So the max time for the given values are x plus y bar plus z, right? So I got another example for the max time. So here the value of x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 0. The resultant max time we can write it as x bar plus y, because in max time 1 means complement form, 0 means normal form. So we can say x equal to 1 means x bar. So max time we join with the OR operator, x bar plus y. Right? Okay, students, that's the end of today's class. Right? I'll see.